A necessary evil. That's what Marjorie Dannenfelser was taught to believe about abortion, and for years she did. So how did one picture change all that? Take a look.
Marjorie Dannenfelser was a staunch pro-choice Republican for years, until she was faced with a life-altering question that changed her mind.
The argument that stopped me in my feet, the thing that made me turn around and walk back my own weak arguments, was the one question pointing to that picture saying, "What is that you are looking at?" I was speechless.
Since then, she has thrown herself into the battle to end abortion as the president of the Susan B. Anthony List. She has worked with presidents and other political leaders in the fight to save the unborn, which she shares in her book, Life is Winning.
Please welcome to the 700 Club, Marjorie Dannenfelser. Marjorie, great to have you with us.
Thank you. What a joy to be with you.
Will you talk a little bit more about exactly what you were taught about abortion growing up?
Yeah, well, I think the most important thing is that we really didn't discuss it much at all. Even though it was a raging issue in the culture, our dinner table conversations talked about everything else. And if the A word ever did come up, it was considered a necessary evil, something that, you know, it's a shame that that has to happen, but people have to have the power to move on with their lives regardless of whether they, and be able to choose whether you want to have children or not. That's how I thought about it. And then I also thought about it as something that I knew, because I didn't see it as any problem, that I would definitely have an abortion if I ever thought that I, quote, needed one. And so my body, my choice, that really shallow mantra of the feminist movement, even though I was pretty Republican and conservative in other areas, really took hold of me. And I think, wow, it's good when you pick a really shallow premise, because it's pretty easy to destroy with God's grace, which did happen.
Well, you know, I think also it's pretty easy to have an opinion about something if you've never been in a situation where it actually needs to be addressed by you. During college, you went through a pregnancy scare yourself. What made you feel furious at that point?
I felt like a trapped animal. And I was going to Duke freshman orientation just in a few days, didn't leave my room, did not know what was going on, until I decided to deal with this with my mom and dad. And we decided, you know, if it's, quote, necessary, then we'll have it all set up. But I still didn't know. And so we, walking into freshman orientation at Duke, I went and made the call to find out, which I thought it would be positive, and then to set up the abortion. As it turned out, with God's grace and mercy, I was not. But what made me furious was other people that thought they could make that decision for me, that somehow they, because only I would have to bear the consequences and not they, made me furious that that anybody could tell me what to do with my life, my decisions, my choices, and my body.
You talked about it a little bit in that video intro that we did, but how did a picture radically change your point of view?
Yeah, you know, so then, you know, God loves the word never. I said many times in my own advocacy that I would never embrace the pro-life argument because I thought it was anti-freedom. But then, because of that, so many people that were good people, non-judgmental people, smart people at Duke, and then in D.C. also, just kind of took on the premise of what I was talking about. And I wasn't talking about what we were actually talking about, the object, the target, the substance. What makes an abortion an abortion involves what? And if you're not willing to look at that picture, look at that thing, the object of an instrument of death, now we know, and say, what is that that's happening? Then you can't really have an informed position and you shouldn't be advocating. And so I did sort of get cornered spiritually, intellectually, emotionally, on that particular issue, and God used all those circumstances for me to be able to get to a result on that very question. I could not say that this is not a human being. I could only say everything about it seems like the beginning of every one of us and has the same potential as all. So my work in philosophy and other places turned me, and then I fell hard after that.
Talk about the progress the Susan B. Anthony List has made in the battle against abortion, because things have changed over the last few years.
They really have. And like every other great human and civil rights movement of this country, there is a time where there is a raw, organic belief that has not been expressed politically or culturally in a really loud and conclusive way. And that is what we set out to do at Susan B. Anthony List, to express the deep pro-life roots of this country through our political process given to us by our founders in order to fix a great human rights wrong. And that means that our desire and our to put pro-life protections in the law is the extension of who we are and what our Constitution is. So our goal was to do this very simple and very hard thing. Elect a president, elect a Senate who will fill the courts with pro-life judges, judges that see the Constitution as we do, so that then we can have cases that are headed to the court all over the country, so that there will be a moment where we overturn Roe versus Wade, and then we have the power back to enact pro-life protections all over the country. That very process, the process of doing everything that I just said, is what rights movements do. And as that is happening, it brings the good news and transforms the nation into what now we see is an emerging pro-life nation. It's young, vibrant, persistent, and we're getting very close to victory. And it's really an incredible testimony to what God can do when we think strategically smart is turning out to be the right thing to do. And that's what's happening right now.
Willing to do what you did, which is examine our position on something and really be honest with ourselves about the reality of it. Your book, I want people to know, is called Life is Winning. It's available wherever books are sold. Inside the Fight for Unborn Children and Their Mothers. And I highly recommend it. So good to have Marjorie with us today. Thanks so much for being here.